Hey guys, how's it going? Eminem Gaming here, and today we're back with another video. And as you can see by the title, we've got a few things to talk about, some Uncharted stuff, some really exciting Uncharted stuff, but Uncharted stuff I need your help with. My subscribers who, really, give me a lot of advice, and stuff. I want your opinion. I really do. I ask, obviously, you guys questions all the time. I like to try and keep you guys interactive, but this is like something I think very important for my channel. Certainly a game I cannot wait for. I love the direction of the game. I love the studio. It's just going to be incredible. So it's very important to me. We've also got another game I just cannot wait for, which is God of War 4, and we're going to talk about that. Leaks, settings, of the like the game and all that great stuff. We're gonna have a lot of it. We're also gonna say rest in peace to a certain beloved sort of kind of not really character from Uncharted, and just give you my opinions on the whole matter. A little bit of controversial, but I feel like anything Uncharted does, a little bit of concept art here, everyone loses their mind. It's just crazy. I think everything Uncharted does kind of gets under the spotlight, and I could not deal with that pressure. Certainly, I don't know how Neil Druckmann and Bruce Straley and that sort of stuff they're dealing with it. But let's just get into this video, guys, and let's get into my plans for Uncharted 4 release, my video schedules, and all that good stuff. So my first plan is now. Obviously, I could upload, gameplay to this channel. I could do a let's play, of the first day or whatever, and that get a lot of views. It's a new game, it's just come out, people want to watch it. But I'm gonna, as a respect to you guys and all that good stuff, I'm gonna wait until I beat the game and then just do a review. Now that doesn't mean I'm not gonna do a let's play. I will do a full let's play of Crushing. Now these can change if Crushing's unlocked from the start, but what I'm gonna do is, this is the plan: beat Uncharted 4 on hard, given some of my subscribers and all that sort of stuff who have the game, maybe not got that far, maybe have to like take breaks and that, got other stuff to do or whatever. I know my friend Valetsu, he's at school, so he's got stuff to do, so a lot of stuff to do, a lot of other people's stuff. I'll be on holiday, I can guarantee you that, to play Uncharted, no doubt. But yeah, a lot of you guys may have to take your time with it or whatnot. So out of respect, I'm gonna beat the game first, then do my review. It's gonna be a non-spoiler review, but bear in mind there may be slight gameplay spoilers in the review. So I'm tempted to just put multiplayer in there, and obviously have you guys trust that I'm not gonna lie and say to you I've beat the game when I don't. I'm 100% honest. My trophies, achievements, and all that are unlocked, and opened for everyone, so you can check that out. But I think I have a pretty half decent reputation to, for you guys to respect that. I'm only doing that so, there's no spoilers in that review. So that's the option that I'm going with. Going to do a non-spoiler review and tell you what I think of it. Then I'm going to do a full let's play, similar to how I'm doing The Last of Us. I do a live commentary. If there's a difficult part, I break it down and I do like, this is how you beat this section or this boss or this, get through this section. I'll do that, very similar to how I did The Last of Us, which is still uploading to my channel. And thank you to everyone who's watching it. I know it's a long series, but thank you for all the support on that. But yeah, beat it on Crushing, give some tips, give some tricks, and all that good stuff. And then finally, get all the collectibles on easy, because I'm not that great, so I can't get all the collectibles on, Crushing. So what I'm gonna do, start from scratch, get all the collectibles, and put it into like one big guide on my channel for anyone who may want to see the collectibles, for Uncharted. It's going to be a big open world, bigger than ever, so yeah, there's going to be a lot of them. And yeah, it'll be like a full guide, like a 10-second clip of me walking to the, showing the area, showing where the collectible is, and all that good stuff. And then finally, after all that's done, three playthroughs down, I'm literally just going to live stream some gameplay. I have someone, I'm not going to say who they are because they may not want to be on the channel, they may not want their gamer tag or whatever out there, but I know he's getting the game. Also, I know Vletsu, big, awesome guy, he's getting the game as well. I think Infinity Games as well as getting it. Just a ton of people who probably subscribe to my channel are probably getting Uncharted 4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and live stream. Now, bear in mind, I don't have the best internet. I'm hoping by June. Hoping. Now, that's a big hope, but it's possible. June, July, I'm definitely getting new internet. It's going to be really powerful, really fast. Basically, I literally went on BT and just searched what's the most fastest, what's the fastest, for uploading and all that. And I literally, that's the package I'm going to get. It's just that I've got, a few things to, pay off and do all this sort of stuff. It's got to be set up and everything. So yeah, June, we're going to have a ton of live streams. If you are getting Uncharted and you're interested in playing on my channel, getting into maybe some party chat, having a laugh, having a joke, having some fun on a live stream on YouTube, we can do that. If you just want to hear me, if you just want to join the party and not talk, that's completely fine. I understand people might not have great mics or whatever, or they might just, want to re-watch me prat around on YouTube or whatever. Yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to have a ton of fun, and I'm going to keep that going every single week. I'm going to try and get at least one Uncharted live stream out there, whether it be just on my own, whether it be with some of my subscribers or friends or whatnot. I think that's going to be a really nice addition to the channel. And I think it's something that, not only do I have a part in, because I'll obviously be playing and I'll be, commentating while live streaming, but also you guys can, be a part of the channel, and that would just be incredible. So, anyway, guys, what do you think of the plan? Do you think that's a good plan? Now, this could go one or two ways. If they unlock Crushing from the start, would you want just a walkthrough of Crushing from the start? Or would you prefer me still at the same time not to touch Crushing from the start, not to touch it, and just wait to beat the game once, whether it is even on easy at that point, beat the game once to do my review? Would you like that, guys? Obviously, let me know down below what you think. And yeah, let's get into the next subject. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a touchy subject. I'm a massive Uncharted fan. I don't think there's any doubt in that. I've platinum, well, actually technically I've only platinum 5, but I'm on my way to Drake's Fortune platinum, and that'll be my sixth platinum, twice on the PS3 and then the PS4 version, a platinum The Last of Us twice. I understand that the Naughty Dog fan base, Naughty Dog community or whatever, is incredibly passionate, and I respect that. I definitely say I'm a part of the, I'm definitely a Sony fan. You know what I'm saying? I'm definitely a PlayStation fan. I'm a Naughty Dog fanboy. Let's just be honest here. But, I'm gonna look at this and try and stay in the middle, of my favorite developer and also the fan base that I put myself in. You know what I'm saying? And it's a very difficult situation because Naughty Dog have took out Donut Drake from Uncharted 4. Now, this is not a big deal in my humble, whatever opinion, bias, whatever opinion. I don't think this is a big deal, but I think it's an accumulation of things. The in-like Flynn sort of thing going on. A lot of hardcore Uncharted fans. I know Robin Gaming was very disappointed in that. I literally don't have the sound on because multiplayer, obviously single player, I've got the sound booming, I'm enjoying the story, all that great stuff. Multiplayer, I'm with my friend and I'm like, where are you? Oh, revive me. Do you know what I'm saying? I ain't focusing on, what the players are saying. But I did a single match and I was like, who the hell is this guy speaking? And then I thought, no way is this Harry Flynn. And it was. I couldn't believe it. It sounds nothing like him. Harry Flynn's got a very deep Cockney accent, and this guy just I don't know where the frig he's from. Do you know what I mean? Like, it was very weird. And he did sound a little bit like a, you know, a joke instead of like a serious character, which Harry Flynn was. I could understand, and Naughty Dog were kind of like, yeah, well, we understand fans' frustration, but we're not going to have him in there. So that's it, do you know what I mean? So I can understand the frustration with that. Donut Drake, if you don't know what Donut Drake is a character which you kind of, I don't know if it's from treasures or headshots or, you know, whatever, but there is a certain thing, you know, like your medals that you unlock. You can get unlockables, you can unlock, what's his name? Donut Drake, and you can play through the game as Donut Drake. Basically, he's just a fat version of Nathan Drake. Now, basically, you've got, you know, people saying they've come under pressure from like SJWs or whatnot, and you know, I'm kind of on the fence with the old SJW thing, you know, the social justice warrior. I respect them trying to equality, but they kind of go a little bit too far sometimes. So I kind of just stay the hell away from that sort of, you know, can of worms. You know, you open that, you ain't putting it back. So I stay the hell away from it. But I don't know if it's so much that. And hear me out here, guys, before you get your pitchforks or whatever. I think it may be just that Naughty Dog, like they said in the statement, is evolving as a company. They started out making Crash, which was just a, it was a ton of fun. I love Crash, one of the great series, in my humble opinion, ever made. I love Crash Bandicoot. What a fantastic franchise that was. And you know, he was a, you know, he was famously just an idiot. You know, he'd turn his head round, you know, wink at the camera while, you know, he's about to jump on a pig. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what we loved about it. It was very childish, you know. And then you moved to Jak and Daxter, which again had a little bit more, I guess, adult humour, even though it was still, I'd say that was more teenage, you know, young teens, Jak and Daxter. And then you got Uncharted, which is that next evolution of gaming. But they tried to, you know, implement a lot of things. Like, they put the precursor orb in there as a collectible. They put Donut Drake, who's just a funny guy. I think they tried to let, you know, make their, what's it I'm trying to say? I think they tried to cater to the Jak and Daxter audience on a big change. But I feel like they've said it one time, they've said it a thousand times. They're evolving as a company. They're trying to be more. You know, they're trying to be more serious of a company, you know, and I respect this decision. Is it sad as a gamer? Yes. Would I have probably gone through my collectible video dressed as Donut Drake? Most probably. Can I understand that people, you know, who have genuine problems, you know, I understand you get the odd people who just like to eat a lot, you know, and who doesn't, but I mean, you have genuine people who have eating disorders who may feel a little bit put out there and a little bit, you know, victimized, or, you know, I'm not saying victimized, but just a little bit, you know, they might feel a bit like awkward, you know, playing in a video game where they're, you know, portrayed as an idiot or whatever, you know, or, you know, portrayed in a certain light or laughed at, you know, and I respect that. You know, Naughty Dog don't wanna upset anyone, but is that the reason? I don't think so, because I think they're just kind of trying to move their sort of brand or whatever to more of an adult theme, and you have to respect Naughty Dog for that, whether you like it, I'm not too sure. But let me know in the comment section. Obviously, I've been rambling on about that, but let me know, what do you think? Do you agree, disagree? Let me know. But finally, 14 minutes in, we're going to talk about God of War. This should be short, but probably won't be. So there's been a little bit leaked news on Uncharted, God of War 4. So as we know, it's pretty much the worst kept secret in gaming that Sony Santa Monica are working on a new God of War game. They're working on God of War 4. I think you'd be a brave man to bet against it. That's all I'm going to say. What do I think of it? Fantastic. I cannot wait for another God of War. It's going to be great. Next gen visuals, next gen gameplay. Cannot wait for it. Now, but the leaks showed concept art. Now, we all know concept art, you know. Jak and Daxter 4 had concept art from Naughty Dog, and that never came true. So bear that in mind, that this could just be complete, you know, a random guy, janitor, you know what I mean, or something. At Santa Monica, just drew this up in the back. but it seems legit. Like, it seems too good, you know, just for a random person or whatever. It seems like real. So there was two pictures, one of just a character, you know, Kratos's build, a very bulky, strong person, more of a human figure, you know. I mean, obviously, I don't know if Kratos was a human or what, but he was very, you know, big and, you know, just completely white and red. You know what I mean? We've all seen Kratos, so this guy looks more human-like, you know what I mean, to me anyway. And yeah, obviously a Viking warrior, so instead of having like the claws, they may come back. You may have, you know, specialist god weapons or whatever, but you know what we saw is like an axe, which was looked pretty brutal to be honest with you. So that's going to be interesting, and it got me to thinking that this most likely, not 100%, but this could be a new trilogy. If you think about it, guys, God of War 1, 2, 3 were just, you know, Greek mythology. You could have, like, this Viking mythology could be the next trilogy, and then you could possibly have Egyptian mythology, Celtic, you know what I'm saying? There's probably tons of stuff I'm not even, you know, understanding. Like, I'm not great with history or any sort of that, so bear that in mind. But yeah, I think this is very exciting for any God of War fans, any Santa Monica fans, any probably PlayStation fans. I mean, a lot of you may be your first game on the PlayStation 2 was God of War 1 or 2. PlayStation 3, maybe you bought it for God of War 3, who knows? But yeah, very interesting information. There's also a very interesting setting. It's sort of like, to me, it sort of looked like a fantasy realm, sort of forest. It was very bright and outlandish and stuff, and I wonder if that's a boss fight, who knows? But very beautiful, looks like it could be an amazing game. And yeah, I mean, I just think it's going to be incredible. And what do you think, guys? Do you think that they were legit leaks? Do you think that that's going to be an actual game? Do you think it's just some concept art? We shouldn't get hyped. Let me know down below. But like I say, guys, as always, this has been Eminem Gaming. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. If you enjoy this content or any other content on my channel, and yeah. I'll catch you guys in a new video very soon.